Good evening and welcome. I'm Kim Roberts Mirandi. I'm the superintendent here in Sutton Public Schools. It's nice to have you here for two reasons. One, in just a moment, we're going to begin to celebrate the hard work of our students, of the teachers, of all the staff who have played different roles in making tonight happen. And the second reason it's great to have you here is we get to thank you. Because all of their success that they're about to experience tonight happens because of their hard work, but because of your support as well. Your time, right, your efforts being here. The things that we all give up on a daily basis to make sure that their experience is as rich as possible. I am extremely committed to the arts. I believe that students are, their lives are richer because of it, whether we are getting to enjoy it or whether we're performing. And so thank you for all that you do to make them a success too. Couple of quick housekeeping items. Let's make sure that phones are turned to silent, please. That flash is off. And have a good evening. Oh, if you have to leave for some reason, if you can wait until intermission, that's helpful. We have just a few minutes in between changing between chorus and jazz band. The exception we always make are for small children who sometimes they just need to get out and stretch their legs. I don't see any here, but if you've got someone you're expecting and they need a couple minutes, welcome them to just head out to the cafeteria too. All right, thank you very much again for being here and enjoy the show.
Warm summer sun, shine kindly here. Warm southern wind, blow softly here. Green sod above, lie light, good night, dear heart, good night. Beautiful and dreamy, yet melancholy. These words, originally from Robert Richardson's poem, Annette, were used on Mark Twain's daughter's grave. Susie died at the early age of 24, leaving Twain heartbroken. Over 100 years later, the composer of Good Night, Dear Heart, Dan Forrest, stumbled upon this poem on the grave in his hometown. His brother and wife, who struggled to have children of their own, were in the process of adopting a beautiful baby girl from Ethiopia. However, they received devastating news that she had fallen ill and passed. They were heartbroken. The poem on this headstone resonated so deeply with Forrest, and we all know when a musician gets inspired, sparks fly. He composed music for the poem, and only 1 week later, this piece was performed in honor of his brother's daughter. While we sing this song, I encourage you to think of your loved ones, even those who are no longer with us.
Thank you. Festival Sanctus was composed by John Lievitt and is an absolute masterpiece. This piece is written in Latin and is centered about praising God in creation, but mainly is a piece that speaks of joy and uplifting the human spirit and will leave a lasting impression.
The Sanctus text comes from the home in the Western Christian literature. It speaks of the Isaiah version of heaven, Isaiah 6, and John's vision of heaven in Revelation 4. It includes a phrase from the Palm Sunday Gospel, "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest." Matthew 21, 9.
Every part is crafted to create an amazing musical experience from the three-part harmonies, beautiful melody lines, syncopated rhythms, and dynamics. They all play a huge part in the emotional tone the song radiates. I hope you enjoy this piece as much as I do.
Petrus, and this is Aaron Pryor, and we want to introduce you to our next song, Hallelujah. The song Hallelujah was first written by Leonard Cohen in 1984, but in 1988 he performed the song using different lyrics in the verses. This started the formation of the many different versions of the song we have today. Each person who covers the song sings it using different combination of the verses that Cohen wrote, thus making each version unique. We are singing the version by Pentatonix, which they released the cover of in their third Christmas album in 2016. The meaning behind the song can be complicated. Hallelujah means praise the Lord in Hebrew, And in his original version, Leonard Cohen included many biblical references, including, "I heard there was a secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord." But taking a closer look at some of his other lyrics, it really shows how Cohen is simply using the Bible to describe what it means to be heartbroken.
Hallelujah was a very powerful song choice. It has a very beautiful and touching message. It was so much fun to learn and sounds amazing with all of our voices. We chose our solos and parts based on all of our unique voice types. Each of us worked very hard individually to prepare this piece for you. We put a lot of time into this song, and we hope you enjoy it as much as we do.
I heard there was a secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do ya? Now it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king.
Hallelujah. They're awesome, aren't they? I'd like to speak to you about this group of students standing here tonight. I'd like to let you know about the incredible people that they are and about what they have succeeded in over the last year, about their commitment to this beautiful art form, their commitment to each other, and the love I feel from them every day I walk into rehearsal. I've been teaching for a very long time, but over the last few years, I've come to realize that teaching the technical, pedagogical, theoretical aspects of music is very important, but fostering a love of music through sharing and expressing thoughts, experiences, community connections, and engaging in activities that spread the joy through music will foster a love for the art form that will last long after their high school years. This year alone, the students started the year preparing to record two pieces of music at a professional recording studio, and they said they wanted to make a CD. I don't know why. They're old, but they wanted something, right? Not just an MP3. Complete with a cover, they designed the CD jacket, they designed everything. Yes, they did it. Next, all the students prepared to audition for the Massachusetts Music Educators Association Central District Honors Chorus. Although not all of them were able to audition due to school conflicts, etc., most of them did, and five of them were accepted. Next, they prepared for their winter concert, and then learned 25 songs for a holiday celebration for the Sutton Chain of Lights and for the Sutton community. Next came the district concert, the All-State Festival, auditions in preparation for this concert, class day, and graduation. Wow, they've been busy. Every group of students has its own aura. Teachers know this well. As we continuously have new classes to discover and understand, but some are very clearly defined. This group in front of you, every single one of them, is wonderful, of course. However, they all love to perform. They are unique in that way. Many choral students are team singers, never really wanting to sing alone, but this crew, whew, all of them want to sing, and they all want to sing the solo. So, I thought about devising a plan for them to be able to accomplish that goal. I made a simple suggestion about a Broadway medley mashup that maybe we could create with an opportunity for duet, maybe, ensemble singing, and they ran with it. The mashup you were about to hear was the brainchild of all of these students.
Hello, thank you for being here again. So as Ms. Kerr said, the next song we're singing is a medley of Broadway pieces. We have solos, we have duets, and we have full group pieces. And I just want to say doing this medley was a really cool opportunity for each of us to choose songs of our own style and for us as a small chorus to be able to showcase each voice.
This piece is by far one of the most fun pieces I've ever done in chorus. My classmates are some of the most talented people I know, and that is what makes this piece so upbeat and special. We have Broadway songs about everything from love, heartbreak, fun, silly pieces mixed in. The song Seasons of Love was a great fit as our first piece in the medley because it perfectly fits how special our time in chorus is. 525,600 minutes. How do you measure a moment so dear? Each minute in the chorus classroom is special, and each person makes someone next to them laugh, even when someone is sad. So I hope you see why this piece is so special and my personal favorite.
Thank you. be popular. I'll show you the proper ploys when you talk to boys. Little ways to flirt and flounce. Oh, I'll show you what shoes to wear, how to fix your hair. Everything that really counts to be popular. I'll help you be popular. You'll hang with the right cohorts. You'll be good at sports. Know the slang you've got to know. So let's start, cause you've got an awfully long way to go.
Cause every night I lie in bed, the brightest colors fill my head. A million dreams are keeping me awake. I think of what the world could be, a vision of the one I see. A million dreams is all it's gonna take. Oh, a million dreams for the world we're gonna make.
Step out of the sun if you keep getting burned. Step out of the sun because you've learned. On the outside, always looking in, will I ever be more than I've always been? Cause I'm tapping on the glass, waving through a window. I try to speak, but nobody can hear. So I wait around for an answer to appear while I'm watching people pass. Waving through a window. Can anybody see? Is anybody waving back at me?
Down ends of smoke, key days, the stale cold smell of morning. The street lamp dies, another night is over, another day is dawn.
Love is where they are.
the shine of a thousand spotlights, all the stars we steal from the night sky will never be enough, never be enough. Towers of gold are still too little. These hands could hold the world, but it'll never be enough, never be enough for me. Never, 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 never for me, for me.
Play the right music, getting into the swing.
You've come to look for a king.
Anybody could be that guy.
Night is young and the music's high.
When they play the right music, everything is fine.
You're in the mood for a dance. And when you get the chance,
thank you.
so many on the way, but the riches will be plenty with the price. And the price we've had to pay, there's a dream in the future. There's a struggle that we have it to win. But this pride in my heart, 'cause I know where I'm going, yeah, I do. And I know we're of
something has changed within me.
Something is not the same.
I'm through with playing by the rules of someone else's game.
Too late for seconds. Sing.
Too late to go back to sleep.
It's time to trust my instincts.
Close my eyes and leap.
It's time to try defying gravity.
They're crazy. Okay. You don't need to count down the days or mark off the periods, semesters, or the school year to measure its worth. This ensemble measures the importance, productivity, success, and the worth of the year by the process of making music together and by the love and respect that has blossomed between these students from many different walks of life. These young people standing in front of you have shared difficult as well as meaningful and joyous moments together. Many have developed long-lasting connections, made new friends, and become an integral part of this musical family. Unfortunately, each year, we must say goodbye to some members of our family, our seniors, who stand here ready to graduate, will soon travel their own path, and make their mark on the world. Let me introduce you to the bright futures of our world. These two students have a combined total of 18 years in the Sutton School musical ensembles. There's only two of them. There's only two of them. Kaya Levine. Kaya has been in the Sutton Choral Program every year since fourth grade, for a total of 9 years.
Kai will be attending the University of Rhode Island and will major in nursing. And Diana Pickett. Diana has been in the Sutton Music Program, sharing her talents between the band and the chorus every year, also since fourth grade, also for a total of 9 years. Diana will be attending Regis College in Weston with a double major in English and secondary education. We would like to dedicate this last song to our seniors and wish them joy, peace, happiness, and lots of singing in their future. We love you, and we will miss you.
For our next final piece, we will be singing For Good by Stephen Schwartz, and this is from the musical Wicked. And basically, the musical Wicked is originally about Elphaba leaving Galinda and saying goodbye to her, and that was her best friend. And overall, the musical just really talks about how important relationships are through life and how much they really matter in making us who we really are.
Although no high school journey is particularly easy, I think the R grade in particular has had a particularly challenging time, only having really half of a true high school experience due to the pandemic. This time was difficult and presented many academic, social, and mental health struggles throughout the years. However, we survived. This is largely in part due to our strong friendships, the connections that we have made, that have stood the test of time and endured even the most difficult of circumstances. Our support staff at the school, who have worked tirelessly day and night to support their students through circumstances that even they did not sign up for. And our families, who have lived with us for all 18 years of our lives, watched us rise and fall, and helped us to get back up again. We chose this song because it acknowledges that while we have all created our own beautiful futures, we did so with help along the way. And although we are closing this important chapter of our lives, these people have been a large part of our stories, one that we could not have written by ourselves.
Thank you. Good evening and welcome. This is the High School Jazz Band, and interestingly enough, they begin their life in November as the pep band starts to rehearse. We go through a basketball season, and then we have a brief transition into conclusion of basketball season to learn something a little bit more traditional and a little bit more jazz-like. As you may or may not
know, the High School Jazz Band performs about 15 to 16 times a year through all of that, meaning that they perform more than any other group on campus combined. They've been together a lot, and they've spent a lot of their time preparing throughout the course of the year and preparing for tonight. We hope that you enjoy the High School Jazz Band. Our first selection tonight is Shake, Twist, and Jump.
Thank you.
ironically, and this is the thing that I find most interesting, I just want you to raise your hand on stage if you happen to be playing an instrument that is not the instrument that you play in band. Just a tip. A bassoon player comes up to me and says, can I play bassoon in jazz band? The answer is, of course, no. You didn't ask me that recently, but that's not the point. Anyway, it's been a lot of fun, and like I said, it's a great group to work with. We hope you enjoy In the Mood. Thank you. one more selection for you tonight. But before we move on to Seven Nation Army, I thought I might recognize a special individual who's been with this group for, I think, at least 5 years. But first off, he happens to be a senior now, and he's been with us through a lot, especially COVID, and the process of rebuilding this group to what it was prior to having not had it for 2 years. So I wanted to take a moment to publicly thank and congratulate Colin Holbrook. Yeah. And bringing us back to our Pep Band roots, we hope you enjoy Seven Nation Army.